Let's take a look at this geometry question from the official sample SAT practice test by College Board. And this is also the last question that they have on the test, so let's see how hard it is. We have an equilateral triangle, and we know the perimeter is 624, and the height of it is k times square root of 3. The question is asking us for the value of k. So, if you haven't done so already, please pause the video, try it first before you watch the solution. Done? Okay, I will tell you guys the answer. K is equal to 108, and we are done. 104, and then we are done. Well, let's see what do we know about an equilateral triangle. So right here, whenever we have an equilateral triangle, we know that all the sides are equal, and we also know the perimeter, so we do this. If we call this x, this will also be x, and this will also be x. And when we add them up, we will have a total of 3x, and that has to be equal to 624. And now divide both sides by 3, we can see x is equal to 208. So each side is 208. And now you might be wondering, k is just the half of it. That is actually correct for all equilateral triangles. Here is the deal. Whenever we have an equilateral triangle, the height goes from this vertex down here. If we take this for the base, I will tell you the height right here. The height is always going to be the side divided by 2 times square root of 3. So if we work this out, h is going to be 208 divided by 2 times square root of 3. So the height is, this right here is 104 times square root of 3. And as we can see, the 104 is the k value. And we are done. Just like that. Now, why is this true though? If you know this fact, of course, you can finish the question in like 5 seconds or 10 seconds. Divided by 3 and then divided by 2. Done, right? But let's take a look at why this is true. We start with an equilateral triangle. The key is we have to find the ratio of each side of a special triangle from here. Have a look. Let's say each side is 2. This is easier because we are going to cut this into 2 equal halves. You can just think about it, if you fold it into half, they will match for equilateral triangles. And this will be 90 degrees. And besides, all the sides are equal for an equilateral triangle, we also know that all the angles are equal and each one is 60 degrees because they have to add up to 180. So that means this right here is 60, that's 90. This and that add up to 60 and they are equal, so this right here is 30. So from here, if now we look at this triangle here, we have a 30, 60, 90 special right triangle. Now, this right here is 2, but we cut this into 2 parts, so this right here will be 1. And as you can see, if you just look at this, we have 1, 2, and we have to figure out the height of the equilateral triangle. And we don't know that, but it's okay. We have a Pythagorean. We can use the Pythagorean theorem. And we can just call this, let's say this is A, let's say this is B, and then the C is hypotenuse. And then just go ahead and work that out. So we have A squared plus B squared is equal to C squared. A is 1. Square that plus B, we don't know. C is 2. That's 1 plus B squared is equal to 4. Subtract 1 to both sides. B squared is equal to 3. And then take the square roots to both sides. Cancel. Usually we put a plus minus here, but B is the side of a triangle, so it cannot be negative. So as you can see, B is equal to square root of 3. So there we have it. The ratio of the sides is 1 square root of 3 and 2. 2 is the hypotenuse. 1 is the shorter side and square root of 3 is the longer side. So if we go back here, this is precisely x over 2. And this is, of course, the x. So we can see that yh is equal to that right there. Just put this right here. Yeah, because you just take this, multiply by square root of 3. Because you can take this as your base triangle, you can scale it up or scale it down. So take this, multiply by x over 2. Take that, multiply by x over 2. That will give you the height. Take this, multiply by x over 2. 2 and 2 will cancel, so just get x. That's it.